Hi there, I'm glad you've joined us for our next video here at Howard Piano Industries. We're continuing our study and our on piano tuning theory here today, and we're going to be talking about frequencies, which are called hertz. We're also going to talk about beats and cents, how they all work together, and those are terms that we use in piano tuning. First of all, I'm going to talk about what's called hertz, and that hertz are the number of vibrations that a certain note has per second. For example, here we've got A4, or the A above middle C, okay, and that they usually refer to as A440. Okay, now if I were to play that, okay, that's A4, and what that does is it vibrates at 440 times per second, and that's what's called the hertz number, because it's the frequency or number of vibrations per second that a certain pitch has. Okay, so A4, the standard for that is 440 hertz or 440 vibrations per second. Now, to figure out anything in relation to that, so we're going to go down and up by octaves. Okay, so if I were to go up an octave higher than A4, okay, to A5, that's going to be twice as many vibrations per second, or hertz, which would be 880 theoretically. Okay, it doesn't always, and you'll find as time goes on, as we learn more about theory and piano tuning, why that's not always exactly that number. But in theory, an octave higher should be 880 vibrations per second. Okay, if we go down to A4, A440, if we go down an octave from A4, then it cuts the number of vibrations per second in half to 220. So theoretically, A3 should have a vibration of 220 vibrations per second, or beats, waves per second. If we go down another octave to A2, theoretically that's going to be 110 hertz, or 110 vibrations per second. So that's how you figure. And then if you were to figure out the notes in between, you would just divide that number by 12, and because we've got 12 notes in an octave, and that would help you theoretically to know what how many vibrations per second should be on each note. Okay, so that's what hertz are, or frequency. Okay, now, as we relate to that in piano tuning, we're going to figure out, we talked in a previous video about what beats are, okay? If you take an octave and and tune it without any beats, theoretically the A4 should be at 440, A3 should be at 220, okay? Now, if we were to deviate from that number by one, by what's called 1 cent. Now let me explain what cents are. In piano tuning, we measure, and in a lot of musical terms that we use, they refer to changes in pitch by cents. Okay, and what they do is they measure 100 cents is the distance from one semitone or half step to another. Okay, so like A down to G sharp. Okay, that's a half step. Okay, between those two are 100 cents. So if you are off 50 cents, you're halfway between the two different notes of a half step. So if say A was 50 cents flat, okay, it would be halfway down to where G sharp theoretically should be. Okay, so in piano tuning, when we talk about cents, number of cents off, that just refers to a portion of how it is between two different notes. Okay, so cents, 100 cents between A to G sharp, or 100 cents between G sharp to G, G to F sharp, that's all divided into cents. Okay, so for example, if we have an octave, going back to hertz, okay, we had 440 hertz and 220 hertz. Okay, now if we raised A4 up to 441 hertz, that's going to equate to about 4 cents. Okay, now we talked about beats in a previous video, one of our last previous piano tuning theory videos, okay, a variation of 1 hertz is going to produce a beat of about 1 beat per second, okay, and I'm going to tune, this is now at 440, okay, but I'm going to pull it up just so it's about 4 cents sharp, approximately. Close as I can get it here. There we go. Okay, now if we listen for the beat, it's right about there. And that's about 1 per second, okay? We know that that's, if I play A4 here on my, if you look on my TuneLab display here, we can see these, I don't know if you can see it, but these little blue lines down here are for 1 hertz, okay? We've got 440 here, this is 450, and then there's 10 little lines. So you can see that's approximately where the first line above the 440 line is, okay? And if we look over here, this number shows you how many cents it is, okay? So it's about approximately 4 cents. It kind of fluctuates between 3.9 and 4.3 and so forth. Okay, so that, and you can hear that that's one beat, about 1 beat per second in there. Now, if we did it an octave higher, I'm going to put A4 back to where, so you can see it doesn't take much movement with the tuning hammer to, move it just to move it that amount. Okay, but I'm going to move up here to A4 and up to A5. Okay, and those are tuned. Now, if I move A5 4 cents sharp, right about there. That beats twice as fast, actually, okay, because our frequency is twice as fast. So okay, so you can see that as the pitch gets higher, because the frequency or the hertz are twice as fast as they are, okay, also, if you're a certain number of cents off, your beat is going to be faster. So four cents off at A3 to A4 will beat at 1 beat per second, and A4 to A5, if we're 4 cents off, it'll beat at about 2 beats per second. Okay, and obviously if we went to A5 to A6 and we were 4 cents off, it would beat at about 4 times per second, which is pretty fast then. So so that's just a basic explanation of what hertz are, you know, how beats relate to that, and then cents, okay? And just remembering, because cents are going to, the term cents is going to come into play and be a real important part as we continue our tuning theory studies. So make sure you stay tuned for the rest of our videos in this series as we come out with those. Again, our website is howardpianoindustries.com.